Hi, and welcome to Talking Tech. I'm your host, Alejandro Rogers, and today we're here in Taipei in Intel's office. I'm here with Patrick, and we're going to be talking about one of the latest softwares and applications that we have developed, and it's called AI Playground. Hey, Patrick, how's it going today?
Good. How are you?
Good. Awesome. To see you here.
So tell me a little bit about AI Playground. I heard that this is some type of kind of software that we're using to help other people that want to learn more about artificial intelligence, mm-hmm. and that they can bring their different type of models they want to use. For example, they want to use a 5.3 when they're doing any type of queuing or any type of like a chat bot, or they can bring different types of models they want to play, different type of diffusion models that they want to play with pictures. So tell us a little bit more about it.
Yeah, sure. So this application is actually created by Bob Duffy and also Lee Kui-chen. These are our, you know, technical marketing experts. And what they've created here basically is an application that's run locally on our graphics AI engine, XMX. And it gives the user several functions like create, enhance, and answer. What we're noticing is that, you know, when we talk to end users, customers, et cetera, we're getting a lot of feedback that they want the ability to run, you know, AI applications locally in the sense of, let's say, for example, I'm a marketing and I'm running a campaign and I don't want all my, you know, campaign products information leaked out online yet. But I need AI to help me to go create those, you know, images, product assets, et cetera. So I can use, you know, AI in this create function and capability to help me create those assets so that it doesn't go online. And then I can wait till the right moment to get it on the web. Similarly, we also have an enhanced picture. Let's say I already have existing assets, right? And I want to, again, go and add something to it, but I'm not a content creator. I'm not maybe good at Photoshop or doing those editing. So then I can use the enhanced features in this app to go enhance the features, like what I did right here, right? I can turn this particular picture and adding that cyberpunk capabilities to this avatar.
Right, so you previously had, you had a picture, you can either create it from scratch, or you can bring your own, and then you can actually come here and enhance it. For example, if you take a picture of yourself, I don't know, outside, and like, oh, put a Taipei 101 behind me, or some problem like that, he will actually go and enhance that.
Exactly, change the background, right? So if it's like, you know, it's raining, you know, when you're doing your, you know, photo shoot, and you want to make it sunny, right? You can then use this enhanced feature to change your background and turn it into a sunny, you know, weather. So we also have the chat function capability, right? And what it is similar to what's, you know, available today, right? And users using the online version. But this is the offline version that, again, runs on our, you know, local GPU AI engine on our Intel Arc. And what you're seeing here is the ability to ask any questions, right? And, you know, run on, you know, different type of models. We give the end users the flexibility, right, to load the models that they want to use that's available online today. And also at the same time, we give end users the ability to, let's say, I have a sensitive document and I want to summarize it, but I don't want that information to leak online. So what I can do is use this feature and capability to help me summarize that information so that I can have it locally available to me.
Yeah, no, that's great. So you can have it locally, you will use that information locally.
Right.
So it doesn't get spread in the internet, yeah. And you can still get a great chatbot that will provide you and help you with all the different things that you need
right.
to do.
Right, exactly.
This is beautiful.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Alex.